Your lungs are the one of the most important organ in the body, and the biggest organs in the body as well. Our lungs are more important because we need them to get the air into our bloodstream so that it can be used around our body. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My topic is all about COPD, asthma, and pneumonia. But first, what is COPD stand for? It's a chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. So, COPD is an umbrella term used to describe progressive lung diseases, and that includes emphysema, chronic bronchitis, and refractory non-reversible asthma. This is also called as a disorder which is obstructing airflow. And it is a ongoing mucus-producing cough. And they said this is more permanent airflow obstruction, especially for adult or old people. So I have listed here signs and symptoms of COPD. Some of the examples are the chronic cough, chronic dyspnea, prolonged expiration, barrel chest, hypoxemia, hypercarbia, thin extremities, wheezing, increased susceptibility to infection, mucus plugs, pallor, cyanosis, hyperresonance or emphysema. So on the right side, I have here a picture which is a person who's having COPD. As you can see here, that person is very thin and is having oxygen therapy due to difficulty in breathing. So just have a look, quick look here. I have here the examples of signs and symptoms of a person having COPD. What are the causes of COPD? Number one, there is the frequent smoking. So if you're a smoker, you are pretends to have more likely to have a COPD when you're getting older. And the second one is air pollutants, especially if you were inhaling gas emissions, you know, the gas emissions from the vehicles. And the third aspect as well that having or cause of COPD is the genes. If your parents are having like the COPD, the children are most likely to have it or inherit the COPD disease as well. So here, the two types of diseases of having COPD is the emphysema, or other known as the pink puffer, and the second one is the chronic bronchitis or the blue bloater. Here in this upper right side, I have two differentiation between chronic bronchitis and emphysema. Chronic bronchitis is, they said, why they said it's called blue bloater, because the person is having a chronic bronchitis is most likely to have a color bluish color due to the lungs is slowly become inflated as the lungs become long. So the person's having they take up more room in the body, leading to more pressures in the stomach, diaphragm, and the intestine, which can cause bloating. So most likely they are overweight and cyanotic. When you say cyanotic, that's why it's called blue, because of this, they call it cyanotic. It is marked or causing bluish or purplish discoloration of the body due to deficient of oxygen in the blood. So that's why it's color blue. And we have also the emphysema, which is the pink puffer. It is a lung condition that causes shortness of breath. The air sacs most likely are damaged, so they are called color is pink or reddish. But the people there, the person who is having emphysema is most likely thinner. So, because as I've said, the air sacs has been damaged. the person is having a harder time to take oxygen to pass into the blood vessels of the lungs, and the body tries to compensate the low of oxygen by breathing more. So the person who's having there is more, most likely the person's diagnosed is losing weight. So I have here also the treatments, smoking cessations, also other known as you need to quit smoking, but also other medications like corticosteroids, even though for those people who are having COPD, the corticosteroids or some steroids are not really helpful, but it helps a little bit. So we have also the oxygen therapy surgery, or this so they have the oxygen therapy. So I show it in the previous picture, the man is having a oxygen therapy in the picture. And we have also the surgery. One of the surgery is called bullectomy. It's a lung volume reduction, or LVRS, or the lung transplant itself. And I have here the words to live by. Wellness is not the lack of sickness, but the capacity to overcome sickness. Thank you. That would be all for the COPD topic.